Today we're going to talk about lead routing. So if you have a real estate team, this KW Command tutorial is for you. My name is Lori Ballen and I have a real estate team here in Las Vegas, Nevada. We serve Henderson, North Las Vegas, Boulder City, where my brother is now, and I'm up here in Summerlin. So let's set up a lead route for your team. We're going to make sure our team is selected. Up next to our name, we're going to use that little arrow and drop down and go to settings. All right, in settings, you can see that we have general settings. There's actually nothing in that section right now. We have command settings, which is where we're going to go for our lead routing. We have connect settings, global settings, and command market center settings. So you're going to go to command settings and we're going to go to lead routing. And then we're going to go to routes. Okay, so when you first log in here, you won't have any routes and you're going to go to create. Now, I'm going to tell you right now that there are some options in here you may want to explore. If you look at the KW Answers website here, let me open that. There is an entire section on lead routing where they explain the weighted routes in detail, time zones, claim actions. I'm going to walk you through some of this, but I want you to know that you can dive into more help with this here using the KW Answers link, okay? All right. In fact, to do anything with KW Answers, all you have to do is go to answers.kw.com and then type in your question, or from command itself, you can click the little question mark up here in the corner and then you start typing in your question like lead routing and it'll open that same page. So I want you to know you always have help at your fingertips from within the command center itself. All right. So the route title, so if you click on these little eyes, it gives you a little bit of an indicator of what it is that you need to do. So in this particular case, it says you have a 30 character limit, name your route. All right, so let's just say I'm gonna call this one IDX leads because I'm gonna route IDX leads to somebody on my team. All right, now you're gonna set the routing rule. So it can be random, which means it'll just rotate to your team. It can be weighted random, which if we look here, I want to read you their exact terminology here. So rated random allows you to create a lead distribution ratio between team members, ensuring that some agents get more leads than others. Later in the process, you will give each team member included in the route a percentage amount that will accumulate equally. All right, so looking at this, if I wanted to make this weighted, then I'm gonna do something like, I want 75% of these leads to go to David and 25% of these leads to go to Jeff. And maybe that's because of the workload that they carry or their options or their availability. Or maybe you have a system on your team where you give more weight to somebody who's getting their 5-star reviews or whatever the reason would be. So random will just rotate between all of your agents. Weighted is going to allow you to give more to a certain person. First come, first serve is the ball jump. Who's going to get to it the quickest? So random will actually assign it. First come, first serve sends it out to everybody and says, hey, who wants this lead? And you got to jump at it to grab it first, okay? Personally, I like the first come, first serve when you know you have agents that are going to grab it and that are available. But it all depends on what your team is. So let's just say I say first come, first served, and then set the route schedule. So now you can do days of the week. All right, I'm going to do first come, first served, Monday through Friday, and then on the weekend, I'm going to assign them all to David or something like that. So you can choose. You can also set your custom times. So you could create separate routes. Like you could call one route floor time, and you can call another route by the, you know, Zillow leads or IDX leads. You could have multiple routes or routes, whatever you want to call them, that go and rotate to the different people on your team based on times of the day, days of the week. So it gives you some flexibility here. And then, of course, your time zone. So in my case, we're on Pacific time here in Las Vegas, so I would choose Pacific time. Now, claim action deadline. If you hover over the eye, it tells you that it determines the amount of time each agent has to claim the lead. Minimum time is 30 seconds. So if you're doing a ball jump and you're letting everybody know, hey, it's first come, first serve. We're not round robining. It's just whoever grabs it. You tell them whoever, you know, it has to be grabbed within 5 minutes. Actually, this is even more. This even comes more into play when you're only alerting one person. So I'm assigning this to David. I want David to pick it up within 5 minutes or it will assign to the next agent. So I personally think this is a must. You know, they have to reply within a certain amount of time. Okay. But that's your call how you want to do that. So I'm going to say 5 minutes. And then, that's funny. It didn't show me any routes with that name when I logged in. All right, let's just call this one then IDX. Okay, then we're going to click next. So then you're going to choose the lead source that is coming in that you're going to set this route up. Now, I already have one with that lead source, so I better test this with another lead source. So you could do Boomtown, Google Sheet, Zero, KW Agent Referral. I like that one. So maybe I name this route KW Agent Referral. So I click the back button, and I would just go to KW Agent Referral. That's actually a really good one for first come, first serve, except I don't know how that. We have to accept that first. So that one I'd have to play with. Anyway, so let's click next and then click next again. So if you're choosing leads to route by source, whether your source is being populated automatically or you are choosing that source when you enter the lead manually, the routing will still apply. So you might have Zaps that are funneling leads into your KW command. You might be using PySync that's putting leads in KW command. You might be running Facebook ads or Google ads or Instagram ads or Twitter ads from KW command, and they're coming in through that source somehow and assigning that source. Like, we know Facebook ads tag it. It says Facebook lead ad. So you could do those. But again, if you're manually entering them, it would apply as well. So now I'm going to search for the agent that I want these leads to go to. But I already have everybody selected here, agents on my team. So let's go with that. Agents to assign route. So I could have all, or I could have only people that I assign. So let's say assigned, I'm going to select the agent. And I'm going to say, okay, I want David to be on this round robin list. And I want Jeff to be on the round on this list for referrals. And Krista also wants referrals. So we'll go with all of them. All right. Everybody but me. Okay. Then we have next, we're going to click save. There it is. Anyway, so here we go. Lead source, KW agent referral, route, type, first come, first serve, all times, all days, and 3 out of 4 agents are on this route because I'm not on there. So then next to this, we have 3 dots, and you can edit or you can duplicate the route. So if you want to do the same route, the same days and all that, but you want to change the lead source, you can just duplicate it and keep going like that. And then here's our paused one. So there's my IDX one. So it was paused. And I could turn that back on. And then it would be showing up here under active. Okay, perfect. So that is how you set up lead routes. Now, Jeff and I were testing this, and there's still some challenges with notifications. So what I'm doing is I'm letting them know that to make sure that they're checking their leads, checking for new leads by sorting from newest, oldest. So for example, if they were to go to their contacts, just to make sure, what they should do is just click the created date and sort it from newest to oldest and make sure that there isn't anything new that they're missing. There's some other ways you can set up some smart views and things like that, but this is going to be an important way to measure the leads that are coming in. As of the last week, we have everything shut off right now because we're testing some things. So I've got all of my leads sitting in a separate spreadsheet, and then we're going to move them all in here at one time. When you have funnels set up coming in from like Zapier and things like that, there can be some conflicts that we have to watch out for. So when we catch something is not funneling correctly, then we turn those off so that we can correct them. This is a beta software. You know, we're allowing them to build it, and we're working within that understanding. So sometimes we have to pause some things and reset to get them functioning the way we need them to be functioning. So anyway, that's how you set up your lead route. I'm Lori Ballen. Thanks for joining me today.